darling. Don't be shy. I promise not to bite until we've been formally introduced. My name's Astarion, and I've spent a century stalking the night, hunting for pretty morsels just like you. A man called Cazador made me what I am, kept me like a pet, forced me to do his bidding. No more. The Tadpole's influence broke his dominance over me, and now I can finally pursue the one thing I've hungered for these long, dark years. Revenge. I'm going back to Baldur's Gate to track Cazador down in his lair. I'll be the last thing the bastard ever sees.
My name is Shadowheart, loyal servant of Shaar, goddess of darkness and loss. There is little more I can tell you than that. My lady Shaar tasked me with a mission of such secrecy that I surrendered great swathes of my memory in order to safeguard the knowledge of it. All I know is that I must bring the artifact I hold to Baldur's Gate, and that nothing can stand in my way. My goddess is watching. Since I was born in the cold reaches of wild space, I have known but one purpose: to wield a silver sword and ride a red dragon in service of my regent, the Githyanki Queen Vlakith. My first step on this path is to slay a Mind Flayer and bring its head to my queen. There is no flesh I will not carve, and no barrier I will not shatter to see it done. I am the one who sunders. I am the Undying Queen's most unshakable warrior. I am Lazelle of Kaleer.
Seven years ago, I was exiled from Baldur's Gate, the city I call home. My name is Will, but the people of the Sword Coast call me the Blade of Frontiers, champion of the meek, defender of the innocent. The truth isn't quite so simple, but they're right about one thing. I hunt monsters, and I always catch my prey. My latest target is a devil, and I'm right on her tail. Once I'm through with her, she'll never escape the fires of the first hell.
Thank you.
What's happening? Where am I? Moving. Someone there. We had a lucky escape, it seems. It doesn't look any better from the outside. Wretched thing. You got what you deserved. Empty. Good. Curious. I feel good. Rejuvenated. Not everyone made it out, it seems. Someone else escaped, too.
This is the pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye. You notice nothing more than meets the eye.
Come to save us from this place. From this place you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return! They return. The enemy. So many enemies. Remove us from this body, from this case. Free us, please. A newborn, born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer, a minion of the mind flayers who abducted you.
Thank you.
In the hells? Are they plants?
Rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this? Squaw. You are no thrall. Vlakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. We carry Mind Flayer parasites. Unless we escape, unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geih, Mind Flayers. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material plane.
Play.
You proved surprisingly adequate in battle. Now, to the helm.
Only take so much. We have to push on before those dragons bring us down.
Go to the helm. Who am I? Your only chance of survival. Now move. You are wasting time.
What have we here? A broom. How delightful.
Faint images appear in your mind. A brain, a Githyanki warrior, and centuries of darkness. Faint images appear in your mind. A brain, a Githyanki warrior, and centuries of darkness.
Are you a pet or a snake? Well, well, what do you open?
Dazed woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you.
What are those voices? Hello?
I hear nothing of the sort.
Really?
Light flickers in his eyes, but he seems totally unaware of his surroundings. Man isn't dead. He's totally unresponsive.
You! Get me out of this damn thing!
We have no time for stragglers.
Good. Try using it on that machine next to me. Hurry! Please!
The console appears dormant. The console hums to life. The pulsing glow and organic lines of the device make it seem more like a beating heart than a machine. Perhaps it will open the nearby pod. Washes over you. Connection. Authority. You feel the biomechanical brain of the console process your command. Runs across your mind. You feel sated.
I thought that damn thing was going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness, because you have a Gith with you.
You keep dangerous company. Fair point. Looks like there's plenty of fighting ahead. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. Shadowheart. One moment.
Let us make for the helm. We've wasted enough time already.
She's right. Lead on.
Steps. All right.
We're nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment.
Kainyank.
Deal with the Geich after we escape.
She's going down. Get out!
Thank you.
happens.
Time to strike. Taste my fury.
With finesse. While they're distracted.
I am fury. I am death. Make way.
Taking position.
It's clear. Hurry before they strike.
On the move.
A better position.
I am fury. I am death. Taking a look. Taking position.
Outmaneuver them.
Time to strike. The Helm's alien transponder. You've made it in time.
Thank you.
sunlight. Your first instinct is to flinch from it and hide in the safety of the shadows. But to your astonishment, there is no pain. The opposite, in fact. Your skin tingles pleasantly, like the caress of a lover who doesn't know any better yet. But beneath the skin, flesh and bone, there is a much more unpleasant sensation. Something nibbles and burrows where it does not belong. The tadpole nestled in your brain. Delicacies might abound. Only one way to find out. And of course, you'll be feeding for two now, thanks to your guest. Until it deigns to feast on your brains and split you open to reveal a newborn mind flayer. Perhaps it would be wise to focus on finding a cure. As wonderful as the sun is, you can hardly enjoy it if your face rips open.
Tread carefully. Running water normally burns like acid, but now, who knows? A quick rummage. Small talk.
You're alive. I'm alive. How is this possible? I remember the ship. I remember falling, then nothing. You might want to reconsider calling her a friend. Looks like she ran off without us. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other, and we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way. Something the matter? There's no story. None that you're entitled to hear, anyway. Just forget you ever saw it. We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly? Must I? Thinking about it won't help. We know what to do, so let's do it. Find a way to rid ourselves of these things. We've no solid leads right now, though. We'd best get hunting. If you discover anything that might help us, I'm all ears.
Is this a good idea, you wonder? You and Shadowheart have a certain rapport, but is it strong enough to weather such a revelation?
You have a faraway look on your face, Astarion. Did you forget what you were going to say? Happens to the best of us.
What's this? More of those wretched things. Spill some blood.
So you're a vampire, Astarion. I suppose I shouldn't really act surprised. The signs aren't exactly subtle, if you care to look. Perhaps I should have said something before you actually bit someone. The distinction's lost on me, if you still feed on blood. Why didn't you tell me? I suppose I can understand that. More than most, perhaps. But no more secrets. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps I'm a better liar than you are, then. All the more reason to be honest with me. I'll see right through you. Now that we have some semblance of an understanding, did you want anything else?
There may be even more that survived the crash. Is that real?
There's goblins over there.
It doesn't look real.
Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
Thank you.
Something the matter? That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. Yes, you feel hate, and you deserve to be punished for it. You should be whipped, made to bow before this creature in shame. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. Minds fuse, lusting for something that is gone. But then its grip claws back with a vengeance, a vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. Monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Monster! Death is too good for it.
If I must. Pleasure. I'll just help myself. Into my pocket. All right.
We get that open easily. Maybe there's another entrance.
Let's see here. Step quick.
Approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
Anyone? Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this.
That magic.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Norse Lloyd as well. Then I can only assume you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region. No use sugarcoating it, is there? The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided. You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. As we've established, few enough can. It's not exactly a common affliction. We're most certainly going to need a healer, and soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together? Most excellent. A parasite shared is a parasite halved, or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. For I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
right away.
What now? Go. It's mine now. What have we here? Broken. Must have been here a while. Another broken trap. I mean, who made these things? Yet another. Hardly the warmest of welcomes.
So let's leave it.
And let the goblins have it?
No. We take it to the group.
Zoru was right. Yellow as a toad, twice as ugly.
The thing's dangerous. Leave it for the goblins to kill.
And if it escapes, how will you... Oh, a guest.
Your skull pounds in response to the prisoner's white-hot stare. Her lips don't move, yet you hear her voice.
Get rid of them.
Demaze, let's...
No. I'm not leaving this fiend with a stranger.
Kill them.
He's right. No one's safe if that thing goes loose. Not even us.
Damaze!
Enough. Lower the trap. Ready your blade.
You've but one chance. Join me or die.
No!
You lying rat!
Thank you. Shall be done.
Bleed for me.
As you wish.
The tadpole hasn't yet scrambled all your senses. Auspicious. But the longer we wait,
the more it consumes. My people possess the cure for this infection. I must find a crash. You will join me.
Careful. She obviously sees your kindness as weakness. Don't let her take advantage.
It is many things. A hatchery, a training grounds, a shelter. Githyanki protocol is clear. When infected with a Geth tadpole, we must report to Augusto for purification. I know my teachings. There are no half measures. If you wish to be rid of the tadpole, you must either be purified or beheaded. Well? You have made an ally from Kresh Kalir. Few know such fortune. Call me Lazelle.
I'll trust your judgment, but I won't trust her. Not until I've gotten the measure of her.
You've a sharp tongue, elf. Would that your mind proved its equal.
Half elf. I suppose the finer details are lost on a creature like you.
Come. The Horned Ones mentioned a camp. One there, this Zoru, has seen Githyanki. A Kresh must be near. We will ask this Zoru where he has seen my kin.
Thank you.